I'm Robin Migdahl, writer at USC Shoah Foundation, and I'm here today with Dr. Kori Street, Senior Director of Programs and Operations here at USC Shoah Foundation. Thanks for being here, Kori. And we're here to talk about 100 Days to Inspire Respect, which is our ongoing education program. So for those who don't know, tell us a little bit about what is 100 Days to Inspire Respect.
100 Days is an initiative that the Department of Education launched to coincide with the first 100 days of the new presidency. The first 100 days of any new presidency is a time for opportunity. It's a time to do something big, to really think about what the foundation we want to set for the next 4 years. And what the Education Department did is they came up with the idea to release 100 new activities or lessons in our educational platform, IWitness, that inspire respect, inspire empathy, inspire civility, develop knowledge and critical thinking among students. And we publish those one a day, every day for 100 days.
Wow. And can you give me sort of a sense of what are some of the themes you guys have been focusing on? I know there's been weekly themes. Each activity focuses on a theme and kind of some of the resources we've seen so far.
So we really thought about what were the themes that were associated with the kinds of ideas and concepts that are important to the Institute. Things like respect, empathy, community. We also have themes where we're taking on the hard issues like hate and intolerance, prejudice, courage. So we're looking at how we can help students understand those from basically primary school right up through high school.
And so what have you heard from teachers? How are teachers responding to 100 days?
I think we're hearing from teachers and students. So the teachers sometimes share with us their students' reaction. One of my favorite was a grade 11 boy who said IWitness was lit. And I'm not entirely sure how and what that means, but apparently it's good. Mm-hmm. We've had teachers who, for example, who did the six-word story in terms of how your story matters. And it was one of our earlier activities, mm-hmm. and they tweeted out all of their class's stories. Mm-hmm. So these kids were identifying the power of love over hate, the ability to counter intolerance with thinking about who the other person is, who they themselves are. And we had a school in Alabama, a Christian Academy, who Mrs. B, who tweeted out all of her classes. And a lot of times what we're getting when teachers register an IWitness is an indication of how much they need these resources. And a big part of why we did 100 Days Initiative was we were hearing from teachers, they don't know what to do in their classes. We've been, for over a year now, really seeing an increase in acts of racism, intolerance, a lack of civility. I mean, really losing our way in terms of having a difference of opinion and having a reasonable argument. And teachers are looking for good resources. They're looking for resources that also meet standards in their classroom. Mm-hmm. They're looking for resources that do digital media literacy, and what's great about IWitness, so we can give them all of that in one short activity. Mm-hmm. And so they're, in their registration, they're saying how much they need this, how much their classrooms are needing activities that help them to unpack these difficult issues. One of the activities we did looks at all the types of isms, right? Mm-hmm. Sexism, racism, ageism, and really help students to unpack why we might have those beliefs and how you counter them. And teachers are responding very well that these are meeting their needs. It gives them something around social emotional learning, but it also does so with rigor. Mm-hmm. And that's so important today, is having those activities be rigorous and rooted in solid pedagogy, and those activities are that.
And so for students, what do you hope that they get out of this when they participate in these resources? What do you hope that they kind of learn and take away from this?
Well, I think I hope that they achieve our learning outcomes. And our IWitness learning outcomes are about developing knowledge, developing skills, digital media literacy skills, information literacy skills. But more than that, I hope they develop empathy. I hope they think critically. I hope they become curious, engaged, courageous citizens who can have a different opinion, can determine what's opinion, what's, you know, an informed interpretation. That they know what evidence is, that they can make a delineation between alternative facts and facts, that they can, you know, believe what they want to believe, but they can defend it, and they can do so respectfully with someone who doesn't believe what they believe. So I hope that we are contributing to making empathetic, critical, courageous kids who are going to get off the couch and are going to help make this world better.
Well, thank you, Kori. And if you want to find out more about 100 Days to Inspire Respect, you can go to iwitness.usc.edu. And if you're a teacher or student using 100 Days to Inspire Respect, please be sure to share your experiences on social media using our hashtag 100 Days for Respect. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.